Have our Women's T20 International Player of the Year Award. How you picked that one, I have no idea. Before we get to the winner, let's take a quick look back at their Commonwealth Games triumph.
It's the gold medal match with Australia taking on India.
The Comm Games gold was something that we all wanted. We've won World Cups before, but we'd never been a part of a world event like the Commonwealth Games.
It was really nice being part of something bigger and part of a bigger team and be able to showcase cricket to the world and achieving something that's never been done before in the women's game.
There were many moments in that final that changed the momentum of the game.
Oh, she stepped across. Has she got something on this? Harmanpreet Kaur goes.
It's definitely something that I'll never forget.
The mighty Australians have struck gold. This team is as close to perfect as we may ever see.
Well, what an incredible team they are. We've run out of superlatives for the mighty Australian women's team. Give them a big round of applause and also a round of applause for Aaron Finch, our Australian T20 captain, joins us. Finchy, great to see you. Commiserations on last night, but you had a wonderful season with the Gates.
Oh, it was a good season. I think overall, the Big Bash has been a great product, and it's great to see the Australian players back playing more and more games. But like you said, the Australian women's team is unbelievable in all formats of the game. They've been the absolute benchmark in world cricket for a long time, and they've led the way in women's sport, not just in this country, but all over the world. So congratulations to you girls, and continue to do what you do.
Yeah, well, beautifully said. You had the great pleasure of leading Australia for a home World Cup. What was that experience? I know the result didn't pan out the way you wanted, but that experience of leading them out in front of a home crowd.
It was different. It was the expectation was obviously as defending champs that we were going to cruise through and it was going to be an easy ride. But the reality is that it's very difficult. Every team in the world turns up knowing the conditions pretty well. So that's a good feeling. Disappointed how that all turned out for us on the field, but can't live with too many regrets.
No, you certainly can't. You've got a job tonight. So it's hard to pick just one standout player in this dominant women's team. Let's check out who are the nominees for the Women's T20 International Player of the Year.
Yeah, the nominees are Ash Gardner, Tahlia McGrath and Beth Mooney.
All right. Here we go, Finchie.
And the winner of the Women's T20 International Player of the Year, Tahlia McGrath.
Congratulations. Must be a huge thrill to be the number one amongst this incredible team. Describe what's going through your mind at the moment.
It's a very special team to be a part of, and I count myself lucky to play on that team every day. And I think that why my job is so easy, because I go to the crease and know that we bat all the way to 11, so I can go out there and play with absolute freedom.
We love your re-emergence back into the Australian team. What's been the key to cement yourself back in this team?
Stripping it right back to basics, enjoying my cricket and playing to my strengths. It sounds pretty simple, but that's the way I like to play cricket is keeping it simple and having fun.
Well, you've done a remarkable job. The opportunity is yours right now to thank many people. Go for it.
I suppose, first of all, thank you to everyone at Cricket Australia and the ACA and for allowing us to do what we do. I've got a very strong support network, so thank you to all my friends and family. And finally, thank you to all my teammates. We spend a lot of time on the road together and, love spending time on the road with you guys and can't wait to get to South Africa with you, so thank you.
Brilliantly done, T-Mac, Tahlia McGrath.